Echo Beats, Mr. 808. Sasa.
Salama sana.
Kwa majina unajulikana kama nani?
Naitwa Frederick Ouko.
Okay, Frederick, have you enjoyed sungura leo?
Yes, nimependa sungura. Na sungura ni mnyama mzuri sana, especially kwa mawaidha ambayo tumepewa hapo ya sexual reproductive rights za women with disability. It is very educative. Yeah.
Do you feel like the film has spoken about inclusivity of the disabled?
Yes, it has started a conversation about inclusion, both in social life, sexual reproductive matters, issues, but also just among friends. Because you see those who are women who are friends, who are having a party and really discussing matters around sexuality and really trying to bust myths around sexuality and disability.
Do you feel like there should be more of these films?
Yeah, of course, because you know society doesn't know much about disability and sexual rights. So we need to have more of this so that we can bust the myth around disability and sexuality. Yeah.
All right, thank you so much.
Asante sana, karibu.
Sasa.
Kwa sana.
Kwa majina unajulikana kama nani?
Mimi naitwa George and I'm a writer. And niliona nikuja leo kuona hii film. I was invited by the director. And it has been a very nice experience kutoka home. Because I'm not usually in social places. Lakini leo nimesema nitoke, ndio nimeona imenibamba sana.
So umeenjoy kuwatch sungura?
Yeah, sungura was informative and people really feel embarrassed talking about some things, lakini kuna vile hiyo ina open up your space na watu wako free tu kuweza kuongea. Yeah.
Do you feel like we should have more of such films?
Definitely. The industry should support people with such ideas. Na kila mtu hadi inclusivity, people with disabilities should get this opportunity to be in film, whether behind the scenes ama on screen. People with disability need to be included in the film industry.
Thank you so much, Fred.
Thank you too.
Guys, I'm here with the lead actress of the short film Sungura. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Kindly introduce yourself.
I'm Florence Njeri. Yes.
Florence, you are acting as who in the film?
I was acting as Kemunto.
How was the feeling for you?
It was awesome because I've really wanted to try acting, and this being my first film, I love after watching it, like, I'm amazed, I'm proud of myself, very proud, yes.
What would you say has been your biggest challenge being on set or shooting? What was your biggest challenge?
My biggest challenge was getting the lines. It was hard. Being my first time, honestly, it was hard, but at least I nailed it. Yes, and also the wheelchair. I don't use a wheelchair, so it was a bit difficult. Yes, it was okay, not new, but I used to play wheelchair basketball, so, but it's been long, so yeah, it was a struggle. Yeah.
You guys were talking about matters of inclusivity. Do you feel like this is a discussion that people need to have openly?
Yeah, sure. Because most of the time, persons with disability feel like we are left out. And I loved what Lydia did with this film. So yes, people should, employers and also filmmakers, everyone should try including us in whatever they do. Yes.
And do you feel like sex education should be talked about more?
Yeah, sure. Like, as a certain lady, the PS, has said inside there, like, some parents, they excluded, like, they assume we know these things, but we need to be taught, we need to be talked to, like, it's a discussion that everyone needs to have. Yes.
All right. What would you say to someone who's looking to act, who's looking to be featured in this industry?
If you really are passionate about acting, just go for it, give it a shot. That's what I did. I've never acted before, so when I saw the advert, I just auditioned and I got in. So yes.
Thank you so much for your time.
Welcome.
Hi guys, I'm here with the producer of this amazing short film known as Sungura. How are you?
I'm quite well.
How are you?
I'm feeling nervous. I'm excited about the response of the film, to be honest. I love that my friends got to see this, like people in the public got to see this, and they love the themes that we got to talk about. Yeah, so I'm pretty excited.
Do you feel like the late nights and the early mornings have paid off?
Totally worth it, honestly. Even just organizing this event, I think it was the stress was completely worth it. The stress of just organizing the film itself during COVID it's worth it. All of it, to come to this and people giving such remarks about the film, absolutely worth it. I love it, yeah.
All right, your biggest challenge in producing this film?
I mean, one, I think it was producing during COVID, because I mean, film needs quite a large number of crew and cast, and having all those people in one location, because we were shooting in a house. So that was our biggest challenge, to be quite honest. Just how to maneuver that, social distance, put on your mask all the time, you know. That was our biggest challenge. And two as well, maybe before we started filming, was funding. We got a lot of rejections before we got a yes. I mean, thank God we got a yes eventually, but also that was our biggest challenge, just trying so much to pitch this to people who could listen to us and be like, yeah, okay, that makes sense, then we can give you a bit of money, because filming is expensive, you know. This is a short film and it did take a lot of money, even just to organize this whole event. It took a lot of money to do that, and we do need supporters for creatives, yeah.
Of course, we've seen quite a number of short Kenyan films. Do you feel like the industry is growing?
Absolutely. I mean, I feel like, especially during COVID, the industry has grown tremendously. Like, in just 1 year, we got 2 or 3 films that came out, and that's new. Before, we could only get 1 film every year that comes out of Kenya. And now we had quite a number. The Softies, the Disconnects, the Sincerely Daisies, you know? And it's growing. Like, this space is growing tremendously, and I'm excited. I can't wait for people to just realize and tap into this energy, like, yeah, we do want to watch Kenyan films, because that's also another challenge. A lot of fellow Kenyans don't want to watch their own people's films, which is sad, but hopefully with the Sunguras, which, you know, like, it's nice and quirky and exciting, then people are gonna be like, yeah, okay, we can watch this, you know. Yeah,
last but not least, for someone who's at home and would wish to watch Sungura, what can you tell them?
I mean, we're going to organize community screenings, yeah? And that involves just going to individual communities, not just in Nairobi, Kisumu, Mombasa. We plan to do around the country. And maybe just watch out for our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter page, and just listen to where we're going to be at, and you can watch that. We also plan to have like an online screening for maybe 2 days. Where people are gonna watch that, give us their comments. Yeah, I'm sorry, but we're not gonna do theatrical runs. Unfortunately, because it's a short film as well, we wouldn't afford to be able to do theatrical runs. So people can't come to the theater to watch. But the community screenings are where we want to tap into the raya to come and watch. Hopefully people are gonna turn out as well. I hope you come out.
I love it. Thank you so much for your time, and thank you so much for creating such a beautiful.
Thank you so much for having us, for coming, for being interested. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'm all in. I'm all in for films like this. I want more films like Sungura. Sungura pushed the envelope. I'm pretty sure they have a like 18 plus rating, which kind of is a death sentence for films everywhere else in the world. But I'm like, let Kenya be the difference. Let's talk about these issues. Let's be real.